尽管病例减少伴随着疫苗接种资格扩大，但由于美国现实的疫情不受控制，加州居民对该州6月15号全面重新开放持不同看法。
No, I think it's too late.
Why do you think that?
Well, I just think that, you know, with the vaccinations and with open air and our attention to things, that we've come past that and that we should have opened up weeks ago, but everybody's entitled to, you know, being careful for themselves.
Was a little bit disconcerting to see so many people, especially on the streets, walking around without masks on. But we wear masks. We're all fully vaccinated, so we felt good coming.
根据加州卫生部公布的最新指南，从6月15号开始，加州人可能会看到所有的工业和商业恢复正常运营。届时，各公共场所也将取消客容量限制和社交疏离的要求。
Until we really understand, the prevalence and incidence of some of these, new variants that may be starting to dominate in certain areas, we still need to be careful about how we handle that. So, you know, when you kind of mix in vaccine conversation as well as masking and distancing and things like that, I am still a proponent, that we should be very careful that we don't just open up completely across the board because we definitely...are not at the end of this.
去年3月，由于新冠病毒的迅速蔓延，加州是美国第一个在全州范围内发布居家令的州份。加州曾经是美国病例和死亡人数的中心。数据还显示，加州已为民众施打超过3700万剂疫苗。